Very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 11th June, on the front page you have three get life sentence for rape murder of 8-year-old in Kathua. So three others have been sentenced to 5 years in jail also for destroying evidence. So these are the accused in this gang rape case of an 8-year-old girl in Kathua in Jammu and Kashmir. So they were convicted by a special court in Pathankot. So the court sentenced the mastermind, you can see Sanji Ram, he was the caretaker of the temple where the crime took place. He is a retired government official and local priest. So he has been sentenced as such along with others. You can see there was special police officer, Mr. Ram's nephew, who have all been sentenced to life imprisonment. The next is Supreme Court to hear plea by wife of scribe held for tweet on Yogi. So Supreme Court has agreed to urgently hear a petition of wife whose journalist husband was arrested by UP police for allegedly uploading defamatory comments on social media against Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath. Below you have Girish Karnad passes away. So he was the writer, playwright, actor and public intellectual who passed away at the age of 81 now. He was Jnanpith Award winner, Padma Shri Award winner. Then on page 7 you have monsoon on course, Goa issues safety advisory. So monsoon is on course, it has arrived Kerala and will reach Goa also. So Goa government has banned fishing, it has also discontinued water sports till August, and these are some of the safety measures which have been proposed, which have to be followed for monsoon. So this helps in covering disaster management topics as such too. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is striking a balance. So this is regarding RBI's nuanced approach in the revised circular on stressed assets, which is praised. So we saw earlier the notification of RBI of Feb 12, 2018 was struck down by RBI because in that there were extreme measures like even one day's default would have resulted in it becoming a non-performing asset. So now banks have been nudged towards approaching the insolvency and bankruptcy code if there are defaults. There is this review period given. We have discussed that in detail in the newspaper. It was in news yesterday. And this is a dozen in one. So this is regarding sports in tennis, the Grand Slams. So it is Rafael Nadal. He burnishes his greatness in an era of greats with a record at the French Open. So he has struck a record at the French Open. He captured the 12th French Open and 18th major overall here. The lead article, Foreign Policy Challenges 5 years Later. So this talks about how in an unpredictable global environment and where resources are constrained, India needs to shape a domestic consensus to have its foreign policy challenges tackled. This is an article on that issue, like how the neighborhood has to be redefined, how we need to manage China and USA. And this is the article on Girish Karnad, the front page news, he passed away. That can be skipped. Then on the op-ed page we have, why language matters. So it says, as the particular language we learn constitutes us and our world, our relationship with it has to be deep. So the three language formula under the draft national education policy was in news. So in that context, the importance of language of or the medium of instruction is covered here. And this is artificial intelligence, the law and the future. So this says all artificial intelligence driven technology will become counterproductive if a legal framework is not devised to regulate it. So this is an important issue on legal challenges of these advanced technologies. Then on page 13 you have Modi to meet Xi Putin at SCO. So the Shanghai Cooperation Organization summit is going to take place in Bishkek in Kazakhstan, and Prime Minister Narendra Modi would be meeting Russian president on the sidelines, but meeting with Pakistan Prime Minister is yet to be confirmed. And here it is, India may give Pakistan its due for action against terror groups. So this is, you know, easing of relations now. So a year after Pakistan was put on grey list by Financial Action Task Force, New Delhi is beginning to accept that Islamabad has taken some action against terror organizations on the ground. Then on international page you have here Iran has accelerated uranium enrichment. So in International Atomic Energy Agency says that production rate is increasing now. So the Iran nuclear deal collapsed because of the USA opting out of it, and Iran announced that it is also abandoning it, and now uranium enrichment has commenced. Then on business page you have government cautioned against rushing into electric vehicles. So this is CM, the sector industry representative, and CII, Confederation of Indian Industries, which have called for a practical approach in formulating electric vehicles related policy for so because if it is ill-timed, it will derail auto manufacturing in the country. And then you have Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation proposes to use big data analytical tools to improve official statistics. So it is also considering establishing a national data warehouse on official statistics. And below you have books. The banks can offer checkbooks for no frill accounts. So RBI has allowed banks to offer checkbook facility and other services to no frills account holders, but it has cautioned that banks cannot ask account holders to maintain any minimum balance for such services. On page 16 you have Coal India identifies assets in Australia for acquisition. So the public sector undertaking Coal India Limited has earmarked 6,000 crore rupees for the purpose too. Then there is no news coverage on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.